You get more papers?
Well, now, this thing here, which, as I understand it from Brenda, she posted this today, and so this includes the warrant that we had last week, or tonight, whichever it is. I'm not sure. We passed this out since there was some discussion. We don't need a whole lot more discussion on it, but...
You open the meeting at 6:30?
Yeah, 6:35.
Yep, thank you.
So essentially what you've got, you're going to put this in the... So what you've got here, first page, is the, what we're operating under now. Next page is the new proposed town schedule. And then just as, so that you can see what other parts of the town do, of the elementary school, you have teachers' union, and from the 2016-2017 to the next one down, it's a, there's a 2.5% COLA, and the following year, there's an additional 2.5% COLA. The B stands for bachelor's degree, so it's a bachelor's plus 15 credits. Master's plus 15 credits, master's plus 30 credits, master's plus 45 credits, certificate of advanced graduate study. And I don't know whether there's a difference between M plus 45 and CAGS. I suspect that you can...
If you matriculate...
Slightly different.
Right, yeah.
They're basically the same.
Right, they're basically the same as far as credits. It just matters whether you matriculate or not.
Yeah. In any of that.
In a specific course, though.
But they get steps also.
Well, if you look, you see the steps. Step 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, through 14.
Yeah, very limited amount of money.
Excuse me? Look at them.
I just did. Step 1, the 2, 17, 18, on the Deerfield Elementary, the 10 cents in step 1 and 2.
Deerfield Elementary teachers, from step 1, 41,439 to 42,937. Doesn't look like 10 cents.
What page is that?
It's probably, it'll say 33 in the bottom, but it's a third page in.
It's about, that's about 1,400.
Well, we have a wage appendix, wage schedule that's...
This is, we're talking right now about teachers.
I don't know what this is, wage schedule.
No, this is last year, it's supposed to be getting 2.5% on top of this.
So this is the, this is the current one that they're getting right now.
Okay.
So, and if you look from bachelor, third, it's step 3, bachelor's. They don't have a step 1, step 2. They eliminated those. To step 14, master's plus 45. It's a 72% increase. And the only difference between those is what their teaching certificate is, or their educational.
Credits, right, yes.
Education. Their teaching certificate doesn't change. It's what their education is. So they get a 72% increase in a total of 11 or 12 years. The grade 20 means that they've worked for the Deerfield school system for 20 years as a teacher. So I didn't include that. You add that in and it increases it to something like 78%. So the...
The new schedule is just a moment then.
Yeah, that's next year's.
Yeah.
And then the year after. The last two pages, or the next to last page, it'll say 21, are the instructional assistants in the Deerfield Elementary School. 11 steps, they start at 13 and go to $17.35. 2% COLA for the next 2 years. And I didn't, that's not, obviously that's not 50%. 13 and 1950 would be 50%. So it's about a give or take 40% increase from step one to step 11. The last page in there has the, these are not nurses, these are LPNs and other
support.
The RNs are on the teachers schedule. And by and large, it's a pretty safe bet that any new RN coming in has a bachelor's degree.
And they also belong to the teachers union.
They do. They're on the teachers union.
Yep.
So the start there goes from $22.12 to $30.62, give or take about a 40% increase. So I just brought this up so you could see how, make a comparison between various compensation schedules. It wasn't that I thought we should study them, but I, you know, they're yours to do with what you want. Anybody want to read this? You might guess, but I didn't make copies. I have something about the housing. Mm-hmm. The 72 condo units. Somebody sent us a letter.
The what?
The 72 condo units.
Oh.
Somebody sent us a letter.
Sent it to us.
Did they sign it?
Yep. Annalee, is that what it
said?
Yeah.
You pronounce the last name, I couldn't.
No, I'm not going to try.
Nice handwriting. I was
here when she brought a lot of this up.
Is she the engineer?
No.
Oh. Or so called
engineer. They were debating this step compared to here.
I know.
My only thing with the salary schedules and that is that I guess my concern is that we're in the very near future here getting to the point where this is not going to be sustainable. Even with the, you know, I mean, obviously we're going to have to do something. You know, the contract, teacher's contract, they negotiated in good faith. It was agreed to, so you can't, you know, you that's right, you can't change that.
We can match it. Mm-hmm. We can match it. Looks like that's what we're trying to do.
You right. Want to match it?
That's what we're doing.
That's what we are doing.
Excuse me. The difference between the lowest salary schedule within a grade and the top grade is 50%.
Mm-hmm.
Teachers are 72%, and if you throw in the cost of living, it's 78%.
Well, I look at our range, and our range is $13 to $36. It's about the same.
$13 goes to $19.50 if you don't increase the job that you're in. It's the job.
I mean, I think it's a mute point. I think it's a discussion for.
Oh, I don't think it's nothing. It certainly is not a mute point. I understand your point, but it's not mute. It's if you're in grade one, it's your job is classified as grade one. That would be like comparing the $13 or the that.
May I ask where we see this going, though? Are we setting ourselves up to put ourselves in a position where we're going to have to, in the very near future, push for a 2.5 override?
The conversation was exactly the same in 2010.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
It was exactly the same conversation. Are we putting ourselves in debt by doing this? And
right.
Now, 7 years later, we're saying, are we going to put ourselves in debt with this? The biggest thing that I see is hiring new staff. We can't bring them in where they belong because they automatically go to, the departments go ahead and just hire them at the steps that they promised them and don't clear it. I mean, this is
right.
The problem.
Well, I know it has been. That's why I'm wondering where this is going to
Well, unfortunately, it's the labor, it's the insurance. It's, forget the labor, it's the budgets in the town, I don't care what they, you know, it's everything. There's not one budget that is less than 2.5%, period, okay? If you take in all the parameters that go along with that budget that we don't see on these, the benefits that should be shown in every budget that go along with these, every budget is outside that 2.5. So that same question is year after year after year. We're going to have to deal with it, and that's all there is to it.
If the budget is within 2.5 of last year's, and the benefit package, which isn't within 2.5, but if it were within 2.5, then the budget would be, even with benefits.
Right, and that's what I'm saying. But when you take that overall, every budget is outside the 2.5, and we've had to deal with this year after year. And so the same question is this, it can go, you can use that same question year after year after year. We're going to head for an override. Unfortunately, inevitably, sooner or later, we will. And if you look on the website, there's already 3 or 4 towns that are at the 2.5% level. Okay, and we're going to get there. The only difference is whether we like it or not, we have more latitude because a lot of these other towns, their tax rate includes the sewer and the water, so they're screwed. They don't have the option of funding their sewer and water separately, and that's inside that 2.5. So, but we have that option, but the problem is, at that point, we can actually have 2.5, we can actually have 3 to 4% in all reality, rather than 2.5, because of the districts being allowed. So you're going to end up with that. And the most we can do is educate the people out there. If they don't want to listen, there's nothing we can do. You tell them that this is what's going to happen, but when they raise their hands, spend this, spend that, spend this, it's out of our hand. The only thing we can do is say, look, this budget is out of proportion. It's up to you people to decide. This is what's happening down the road. Mm-hmm. We're maintaining a 2.5 budget. We're spending 3.5 to 4. It's very simple math. If you want to continue to fund every budget, be aware that there will be consequences down the road. And I agree with you, Jeff. I agree with you, Bruce. But the reality is, I also agree with Mary. These rates are obsolete.
Yeah.
I know you're not, but you know, all points are valid. All points are very valid.
I think
valid.
It needs to be slower, the increases.
I think what should be done is, there again, I mean, this is subject to change annually. Unfortunately, we are backed up against the wall right now for time. So the best we're doing is, you know, whether we recommend this plan or not, it can be changed next year, okay? And, you know, it's so far out of whack right now. It's so far out of whack right now. The Personnel Committee is going to need 2 or 3 years to iron this out and get things back into perspective where they really belong, because the labor market is getting smaller and smaller. They can't hire licensed water people. They can't hire wastewater treatment plant people, equipment operators, and forget the town, but as far as electricians, plumbers, young people are not getting involved in this stuff. Yeah. And the only way to compensate is to raise the package. Whether I say, yeah, I wish I had that kind of package when I was working, but, you know, that's what, you know, we all do. That's, you know, so I think we're beating this horse to death. This can be changed next year. You know, so I don't think it's unreasonable if you look at the thing right now for the one-year package. Overall, yes, it needs adjustment. But as far as the present, I don't see an issue with it. My opinion.
One of the questions that I would ask is, if you were going out, Bruce, I don't know what your business was, but you two, if you were going out and you were hiring an electrician, I assume if you take somebody that's coming directly out of the tech school, you're not going to pay that person at the top rate here. You're going to pay them toward the bottom.
Yes.
And yet, if you hired somebody with 10 years of experience, can you hire anybody for $20 an hour?
I've been on the market now for 7 years, so I don't know.
I doubt it, no.
It's a different private, I think it's different private public, too.
Yeah.
Talking apples and oranges.
Yeah. I don't know whether you could or not, like I said, I've been away from it for 7 years, I would doubt it, so.
I mean, I don't know.
Not without, you know, there again.
Let me ask, once again, if we're gonna do a new hire, what's gonna be the process now? Are we gonna go through the personnel board, and the personnel board recommend the selectmen? Or are the selectmen just gonna step in and say, oh, we need to put them there?
We've had this discussion with the selectmen, and we said that we could hire somebody within the first and third maximum, because some people come with a lot of experience, and you can't pay them at the basic rate. So, one, maybe first, second, or third, you could pay them.
Stop.
All right? The agreement is that it won't happen unless the personnel board approves it. And we're not gonna get into the mess we got into last year. That's what changed everything in this place.
That was my point, thank you.
But unfortunately, that's only a verbal agreement.
True.
We don't know what will happen.
Yeah.
But the hope is that someplace along the way, we've at least brought some sort of order to this.
Yeah.
Right.
That remains to be seen.
Right, yeah, you know, and there again, I said, it needs tweaking, but, you know, we're at the 11th hour with this, and I don't, you know, I don't think this year the proposal's out of range.
I don't think it's that far out, especially if they're putting people where they belong in the schedule.
Well, that's the key.
That's the key.
That's my biggest concern. Are they going to place people in due process through the personnel board, you know, the committee?
And I would.
As far as recommendation.
Our recommendation was to place them closest step.
Right, but I'm saying in the future, new hires, right, new hires.
That's.
Is it going to go?
You're gonna lose another whole personnel board. This is the reason you don't have a personnel board.
Right.
Because every single thing they've ever done has been turned over. So, we have to have a stronger personnel board. We have to, you know, either make it a public issue or what, I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
I mean, why would you spend all this time researching this information and then have it overridden?
Right. No, I agree, and that's why I say, you know, these committees, you're asking people to get on these committees just to simply either override them or not follow the proper process.
Right.
That's an issue.
I guess the one thing I still object to is if you're on a personnel, do you have any idea what a highway equipment operator is that requiring a license?
They have to have a hoister, they have to have CDL.
Okay, so there's nothing below heavy equipment operator in here.
What do you mean?
There's no position for labor here.
No, because they eliminated it. They made everybody top dog in there.
No, everybody has, I mean, all the equipment has to have licensed operators.
I understand that.
Yeah.
But they're not all licensed.
I don't know.
Well, I'm telling you they're not.
Yeah.
But if they hire somebody new, they can't hire a laborer just to do.
Well, that was what step one was.
Well, I don't know that that's.
Mowing grass.
Mowing grass.
Yeah, I mean, that's.
It used to be a laborer's position.
There used to be a laborer in there.
Yeah.
And they used to pay the guy, and after the guy would get all the licenses, then they would bump him up.
Right.
Right.
But now they start everybody at the top pay. And don't worry about bumping them up and let train on the job.
They started all but one at their basic rate. They started them at step one. There was one that came with all his own equipment, and he had a lot of background, so he did not start at step one. As he shouldn't have. He should have started at least a three for what he came with, his package that he came with.
The last guy?
I
think it was a mechanic.
Yeah.
Oh, well, the last guy came with a whole bunch of licenses too.
Right, yeah.
You know, so.
Yeah, he's well.
Oh, yeah,
above.
Yeah.
I mean, Kevin.
And I'm not arguing that, but I'm arguing it. So when you're posting for a licensed individual, so you're narrowing down the field.
Yeah.
Because if he doesn't have a license, he can't apply for the job. So you can't have a laborer's job here in this town.
Well, first step. That was supposed to be.
Well, it says very specifically, it says landfill attendance and library.
Well, I don't know why that's put in there like that.
No, and if that's where it's supposed to be.
More than what the term was supposed to be. The term was supposed to be new hires, probationary or whatever.
Oh, okay, all right, because that is not, it's not what's written.
But not necessarily, I mean, you hire an equipment operator, they're not going in at grade one.
No.
They're going in at grade two.
Right.
But, you know, part-time people, the people that, you don't know where to put them, I guess that.
Exactly. If somebody who hasn't been tested, basically, we supposedly have a six-month trial period.
Probation, yeah.
Or probation.
Yeah.
And that's, if they're laborers, that's where they should be.
No, okay, well.
Yeah, and, you know, the thought, and I think it makes sense, and it hasn't happened. We hired a couple of college students in the summer to go mow lawns. Do they need any, you know, other than being told to keep their fingers out from the mowing deck? Could you send them in a pickup truck with a mower, and I don't know if you want to put a trailer on it, but.
Well, they would hire laborers to be brought around to the jobs, and according to Kevin, they would be going with somebody else.
Probably working with them anyway.
They'd be working with whoever they hired, so, according to what Kevin said, anyway.
So this other one.
If you run, if you have a guy running a piece of equipment, a lot of times you have a ground man right there to assist in either pushing in snow or whatever else, or directing traffic. So you don't need all licensed guys to run equipment all the time, because they're not all doing it.
Correct.
They don't have enough equipment.
They've got enough equipment to do it.
Yeah.
They're not gonna have all one time.
That's right. My only concern with this whole plan is the 5% every year is unsustainable, and if the teachers and other people can get 2 or 2.5%.
What's that?
Is it 5%?
And since it's inflationary, and I do want 2.5%.
It's five, it actually works out to 5.5%.
Really?
It's an average.
Between step one and step two, it's the dollar amount stays the same, so that 5.5% would slightly work down as you go up, but that from step one.
What I'm saying is that anything over 2.5% does not even meet the basic state guidelines, which says you're limited to tax increases to 2.5%. So when you turn around and add 5% in there, we just can't afford it. And even though we said this 7, 8, 10 years ago, and we said it 20 years ago, the fact of the matter is we keep running out of options, and we still haven't even figured out whether we can finish this budget now this year. But the bottom line is we can't afford anything more than 2 or 2.5%.
I did a calculation with a 20-year step at 2.5. Mm-hmm. And I also looked at longevity, how that affects the increases at certain rates, and typically about half a percent. So once you, once you reach 10 years, you're getting 2.5, well, in my
problem. You get $200 stipend.
And you're getting a total of 3% raise every year. Once you reach longevity.
Once you hit 10, you stay at 10.
When?
You stay at 10, and then you add your longevity.
Mine stays at
10. And usually they give you a cost of living adjustment, too.
And plus a COLA.
Yeah.
So even with a 10, when you go at 5% or 5.5%, the longevity is about 0.5%.
Yeah.
So you're actually at 6 plus a COLA.
But you're talking step plus a
second.
COLA.
How do you come up with it? When you add longevity, somebody at step one isn't going to get longevity when they go from 1 to 2. No, they get it after 10 years.
After 10 years.
So they're not, but they.
I'm saying when they reach the time when they can get longevity, their rate increases by 0.5%.
Once every year.
Once you've got the 400,
you get it every year.
Yeah.
You get it every year.
But it's you. That's right. But if you were making $10,000,
well, what they do is they also give you a cost of living adjustment on top of that.
And you got a cost of living adjustment of 2.5%, which would be what, $250.
I don't know where they keep getting these false cost of living adjustments, because I've been arguing for years we should use the federal one to give to federal employees.
All I'm talking about is if you give somebody making $10,000, you give them $400 longevity, and they got no cost of living raise, what would they get the next year?
$400.
$10,400. So they got, so they got no raise the next year.
Right, they got a half percent.
They did not. They went from 10,400 to 10,400.
They didn't get longevity?
The 400 was the longevity.
They get it the next year.
They do, does not accumulate.
Yeah, the 400 does not accumulate on their wages. It's a separate.
No, I understand, but it's.
Like the cost of living adjustment. Normally, they say, well, we can give a cost of living adjustment to anybody over 10 years.
Well, that's what we used to say.
And they use the one that they use out of Boston, so we pay two and a half percent.
Well, nobody's seen 2.5% except the schools in a long time.
Yeah. Well, I guess what I'm trying to say is if you look at the schools, because that's what our employees do, they look at the schools and they say, look, you get a teacher starting off at $43,000, and they're going to go in 10 or 11 years to 65, 64, 65,000. That's a 50% increase. And that's just on the bachelor's level. Never mind if they've increased their education.
It's a good profession to be in.
That's right, it always has been.
That's right. Nothing wrong with being a teacher and getting paid for it. If you want to be a clerk, you can be a clerk for the rest of your life and not be a teacher. I don't think we should be playing one against the other.
No.
Well, if you look at instructional assistants, they're doing.
They're not teachers. They're not teachers, right?
No.
And they're getting.
They're not getting much.
From $13 to $17. I realize that's not 50%, but it is 40%.
Now how much do we get?
50%.
So it's less. Instructional assistants get less than what we get in our step, 10 steps.
They in 10 steps, in 11 step, they're going to go from 13 to 17.35.
Yeah, and what are we going to?
From 13 to 19.50.
Right, so I'd rather be, instead of instructional assistant, I'd rather be the guy that collects money down at the Tri-Town Beach for 10 years. Right? Make more money after 10 years.
You do?
You just said 19 compared to 17.
How many hours do you work in the course of a year?
You only work like
so you
only
work all these
5 or 6 weeks.
Part-time jobs.
Right.
So the instructional assistant is part-time only to the extent that they're working 39 weeks instead of 48 weeks.
Right.
I see your point, Bruce. I understand what Bruce's point
it's
is.
Fine.
I don't
want to argue about this. I think it's we have a public hearing coming up. If we have to, as a board, make a recommendation on this?
We don't have to, but we typically do, I think.
On the compensation plan?
Compensation plan. It certainly is a financial.
Yeah, it's
going to affect the town. Well, I think when we approve the budget, we've accepted the financial and the comp plan.
Well, maybe. Although if the comp plan were to change on town meeting floor, then the budgets would change.
At least well now.
But so far we've approved all the budgets at a higher rate to the new comp plan. So basically, we're endorsing it.
Yeah.
Right, exactly.
Without even having to vote it. Because basically on all the budgets that we voted, right, they were calculated at the new rate, and they've all been approved, so.
What would you have us do, I guess?
No, I'm just saying. All I'm saying is, it's just a fact. That's what it is, Because all the budgets that we're receiving here are based on the new rate, right? And if we're approving them, then obviously we're indirectly approving the new rate.
Very indirectly, I guess, but anyway. Right. So look,
you know, the only way that's going to change is, like you say, on the town floor at the annual town meeting, if people vote any of the budgets down. And then you'd have to go back and revisit your salary schedule.
Or revisit whatever.
Or revisit whatever, right, yeah.
I mean, hopefully the comp schedule's on the warrant article prior to.
Right, you would hope that would be the case.
It usually is one of the first couple of items.
Right, and if that's, that would.
Of course, since we haven't put one out there for the last 7 or 8 years.
Right, that would set the tone though, so everybody knows.
I asked Brenda to do up this revenue thing, to give us it, it's a starting point. The tax, property taxes are this one here.
Right, yeah.
To give us an idea of what the property taxes, of what all of the revenues are that we've got. So you, the property taxes there, that also includes, I don't know exactly what that includes. We need to expand that to show the, those items that, where we've got debts.
Personal property.
Property?
I don't know if that should, that doesn't include personal property.
Yeah, it does.
It does?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's the total, right, I think that's the total personal property and property tax.
Not if you wanna talk about automobiles. Because that's down below, but it does include property.
Right.
That does, doesn't it, Bruce?
What's that?
Property taxes.
It's all-inclusive?
Yeah.
Yep.
That includes the personal property.
Generally. Where are you looking at that?
The top line, I just didn't, I thought that was just real estate.
Motor vehicle.
No, I'm just looking at real estate, that's the tax levy.
Yes.
Oh.
Right at the top page, top of this one.
Oh, yeah, that, yeah, that, the tax levy, yes, that includes the personal property.
So we need, we should break that up so that.
Well, no, I didn't really matter.
The debt exclusion is shown separately, so you see them both. Then you've got state, the cherry sheet. And you can see that one doesn't change much.
No. Charges do.
Yeah, one point, one point.
Yeah, they beat us up on charges occasionally. And then local receipts, those? I don't know whether those are actual, those are estimates, so.
They always are estimates, and you have to have it within a range so the DOR doesn't.
I know, but for discussion, so that we know what we actually have for dollars, we really need the actuals. You obviously can't get the actuals for 17 or 18, but you could get the actuals for 14, 15, and 16. So that we can see how many dollars we're actually bringing in.
Yeah, there is another sheet for that, I think.
And then
historically, that submittals is extremely conservative and come in, hope you had every year.
Yeah.
By at least, well, in fact, it's at least 20% under.
Well, like I said, if you put it too high.
Well, yeah, you can't.
They question it.
But the point, I guess the point is that if you actually say, well, what do we have for revenues? What are our revenue sources? We have three revenue sources. We have taxes, property taxes, we have local receipts, and we have state aid. There are no other property, well, we get a few dollars that are given to us, the gifts that we get. But free cash is not a revenue.
No.
It's money that was left over unspent.
From the other three items.
Yeah, or where we under budgeted, in particular, local receipts.
Mm-hmm.
Under other funding sources, I don't think the skin's reimbursement line is correct.
60?
For 17, 115,000?
Where's that, Bruce?
Where is that?
Second. The third line down, other funding sources, schemes reimbursement.
You got 60,000, like last year you talked about?
Last year was 115, I don't think we got that.
But they paid for 2 years.
That's for 2 years.
They didn't pay for 2 years.
Yes, they did.
Yeah, they did.
They had one in their budget for 1 year, and they had the separate article to pay the back tax.
But that's more, okay.
Then why do we have a negative 55,000, 56,000?
Because that's a change from fiscal year 17 to 18.
Oh, okay.
So when we bill them for administrative services, don't we have to, I mean, we're part of the group, so we only get 50% of that.
Right.
We don't get all of.
No.
Well, we get 100%, but we do pay in 50%.
We get 60 in and pay 30 out.
The net.
That's 30.
Yeah, that's 30, right.
But it's 30 better than we would have gotten.
No, I understand, but this says we have other funding sources of 90,000, which is not correct. Because we have a, what is the money out show on this show? Doesn't.
It doesn't, this is just revenue.
But what only revenue we're really getting now is, say, 30,000. We're not getting 60.
It's a bookkeeping or accounting.
That goes into free cash, that's the issue. That's the money they charge them, and then it goes into free cash because it doesn't go into any certain fund.
I understand, but it's only 30,000, it's only half.
It's a free cash withheld.
That's my understanding.
What's that?
Free cash withheld.
Yeah, those numbers are kind of crazy.
Beats a hell out of me.
Well, I can see it on the other one because that could be what we used for free cash.
475?
Yeah, or we left a balance of 475.
Well, I'll tell you what, we certainly did not have free cash that we carried over $942,000.
No.
That's
not what that number is.
It may have been that we had $475,000 at the end of the year that we did not spend.
That I understand.
That one I think is what that.
I don't understand the 2018 one, is what I'm questioning.
She may be doing this to balance the budget.
I think that's it.
I think that's a paperwork entry only.
I think if you take a look at what we've got here.
In other words, we could use $649,000.
We still have 649 instead of a half million. So if we want to spend extra money, yeah, and start putting money away for something else.
So we're projecting.
Well, how much did we use last year? 900.
Last year we left only about 300,000. Yeah,
475, I'd say.
Yeah, 475 is what we're saying, but I thought it was less than that, too.
I thought it was less, too. I thought, like John said, I think it was a little over 300, yeah. Right? Yeah. That's what I thought.
So we're anticipating $1.5 million in free cash?
It's already certified.
That was certified.
Well, no, the certified
in October last year.
Right.
Was it 1.5 million?
5.8 million?
Yes. That's the correct number.
1.5 million.
So then we use 936.
Well, no, we haven't. That's the question I have.
Apparently, too.
No, I think what she's saying is that if you look in here, we would need to balance this stuff, take $650,000 out of free cash in order to make all of these things that we've approved.
I think what they're saying is that we've got to take $936,000 to balance that and leave in 649.
That's how I read it.
Well, I would too, except for the fact that if you go back to the prior year, what we left, what we carried over was the 475.
Not the 9.
But we haven't, this doesn't include all of the expenditures either.
No.
So.
Forget I even asked.
No, it's all right. It'll be fine. The highway and wastewater treatment plant salaries were incorrect for Kevin.
Yep.
So those have been changed and they're here. So we need to vote.
Read the bottom?
Yeah, so if you look at, I think she's entered in here the new numbers, but I.
Yes.
Okay. And. Let's take a look and see what we
we voted yesterday, so.
Right here, yeah.
Do you have it?
No, in minutes.
Oh, all right. You said you weren't gonna have it done, so.
No, that's okay.
That's fine.
My goodness.
Yep. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Great job on minutes.
You got yourself stuck, you know.
Wait for that cash to come off.
No, it's not coming off.
Not coming off.
Not this season.
Not this year? Oh, well.
Maybe Monday.
No, that's good. Well, you still won't be able to use it.
So what did we vote for then?
We voted.
252,164.
Highway Department, no.
Highway Department.
439,052.
439,052.
439,052.
First page.
Yep.
So we would.
Going up $2,000.
Somebody wanna make a motion?
Make a motion.
So you're.
At the new rate, I'm sorry.
Yep.
Motion.
So the motion is to.
Change it to 441.
Change highway salaries to 441,558. Any debate?
No.
Questions? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Is it unanimous?
Yes.
Yep.
Okay. It was 6-1. No, yeah, so I assume probably John is the. Okay. And wastewater treatment plant, same thing. Salaries, just not the, we did not vote the waste, or we did not approve the wastewater treatment plant.
We can revisit that, though, right?
We, oh, yeah, no, we can, we'll have to revisit someplace along the way.
There was just enough questions.
There were too many questions on that.
Should have put it on hold, but we decided to vote on it.
I had that as a 2-4-1 vote, I think, on mine.
4-2-1.
On wastewater treatment.
On wastewater, it was 2-4-1.
2-4-1?
Yeah.
I had 4-2-1.
4-2-1.
2-4. There are only two of us that voted in favor of it.
Right. Two favor, four against, the one abstaining.
Okay.
All right.
I had.
You got 3-3-1, yeah.
So it was 2-4.
1.
2-4-1.
Yep.
I told Carol, we need to talk with them about that, so. All right, for wastewater treatment plant salaries, the request is 252,665.
So you have the same issue, we're going down, the operators going down?
No, the issue here was Kevin's salary was at a step 8, it should have been a step 9.
Right, but how about the guy who's taking a cut in pay?
Right, because he's supposed to come up a step.
Yeah.
It's still shown as their cut in pay.
Right.
Yeah, that should be.
Who's that?
Benoit.
Benoit.
It shows.
Still down 63 bucks.
Yeah, something's gonna be done about that.
Yeah, it asked, okay. So let's just leave it then.
Put that on hold.
I'll ask. All right, so that one's on hold. Okay, what's the last thing we have here?
Hims, capital expense.
Yeah, let's do the minutes if we can first.
Okay.
Get those done. So you've got the minutes of the March 21st meeting?
Yes. I made that one correction already, so. I had a joint meeting at Finance Committee at 6:30. That's what we thought we were gonna do tonight.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Yes.
Yeah, that should be okay, because we'll eventually go in there.
We've already opened the meeting.
Right.
Make a motion, may I approve it?
Second.
So Motion to approve the minutes as corrected, I guess. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? It's unanimous.
Are we gonna wanna just make note on that salary, though?
I'll
On the wastewater?
Yeah, we'll have to do that one. That one stays, we didn't change the.
Right, minutes per se, all right.
Do you want, is it not listed?
Yeah, the dollar amounts are listed.
No, I mean, for the, Chris, did I not put a note by?
Yes, there is.
Yes, you did.
So I'll look. One operator decrease.
Right, should be prorated, right?
Reduced.
Must be reviewed, yeah, okay, so that'll suffice.
So you've got the, without any detail, you've at least got an idea what the SCIMS budget looks like. I haven't even looked at it, so, excuse me.
I heard that there was a travel, line I had for travel, $1,500 for travel.
For travel?
Yeah, to and from somewhere. Looks like they took it off.
I would like to ask for a breakdown of those. Salaries and wages.
What was that?
Second page, Bruce, just before SCIMS intercept piece, for $2,000.
Yeah, I don't, was it minus, I don't know what that was for. When I was listening, I just caught the end of it at one of the meetings, but it was my impression there was something about travel for the second crew to go back and forth from Deerfield to Whately.
Right, yeah.
But the driving ambulance back and forth. And they're parking the car in Whately. Unless they park the car in Deerfield.
And walk there?
And one guy drives.
Oh, for him.
I don't know.
It was, well, yeah, it made you wonder.
Are they parking there and then reporting to here and then being required?
Required to go down, drive down.
Rather than being required to report there?
Yeah, I think that was going on.
That's bull.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Are we gonna have them in? So just hold on this and.
Well, no, I mean, what kind of questions do we have on here? One of the ones that I would like to see is, I would like to see a breakdown of the individuals and their salaries.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Like we have for every other.
That's number two.
Pardon?
That's number two. Number one is explain why the director's getting a $6,500 increase.
Yes.
That's number one.
Well, I can tell you why. I can tell you why. Well, I heard that. He asked us, the personnel committee, to go from 70 to 75, and we didn't get an answer yet. I'm just saying.
We didn't get an answer because he hasn't shown up at the meeting.
And so all the increases, $1,500.
So he added $1,500 interest on for not getting an answer.
This year's increase.
We requested him three times to come to a meeting.
2%.
He needs to be on the schedule. All of you need to be on the schedule. All staff needs to be on the schedule.
What's the rate on the schedule for him? Yeah, we decided that we should put them all on there, right?
Yeah, well, yeah. They're listed.
Yeah. Well, I guess intermediate wasn't on.
Intermediate wasn't the only one that wasn't, and that should have been added. It was shown on 2010 schedule.
Right.
So it just needed to be added. I think it was a step three. Or two or three. And basic must be two and there were three intermediate. So salaries is the first thing, and
The first one is the director's salary, and number two, all other salaries, and number three, call staff salaries.
Yeah, that's.
They still got $167,000 in there, and they get a full contingent.
Call staff salaries are higher than the staff salaries.
No, they're not.
No, they're not.
No, not anymore.
$445,000.
No, I'm saying per person.
I don't know. Well, yeah.
No idea.
per person, I think they are higher, because that's not supposed to include benefits.
I'm just saying.
I agree with what you're saying.
If call staff is.
That's why I'd like to see a breakdown, because when you add all that up together, you're talking $700,000.
There's a question about the overtime too.
Lot of questions. My understanding is that they're running $100,000 in overtime, and my understanding is that they turn around, somebody said, well, I want to take the day off and go and have a coffee with my girlfriend. So they say yes, and then the same guy turns around, takes all the overtime, and keeps stocking up the overtime. So there's no control. Here we're paying for top quality management, and we're not getting good control over it.
There's items that are highlighted on this sheet. Is there a reason for that?
I have no idea.
I think there might be that they're not been determined yet. Because I know that the retirement was an old number, I think.
And they should have a new number.
I'm saying.
They shouldn't have it, because they got the letter already.
We need one of these. And actually, I'd like to have two of these, just for South County EMS. One for the current year, one for the 2016, so we can see what that is.
What are you asking?
About 250.
Detailed expenditure.
For 15 and 16.
Well, yeah, 15 if we can get it.
15 was part year though.
No, it was actually a full year.
I thought it started January of 14.
But what we can get from that.
It was, but they never got it off the ground, right?
What we can get from that is we can find out how many dollars they brought in. We can find out how many dollars they spent. We can find out what the surplus was.
Yeah, then.
Retained earnings, because they've dipped into that. We can find out what the retained earnings were from last year as well.
Yeah, then we'll show that.
So, and we can get, and we can start to get an idea of what retained earnings is looking like this year.
Mm-hmm. They do show numbers for retained earnings. Who knows how you figure them? I mean, none of these numbers are what I recall. The capital came out of retained earnings.
So, Bruce, where did you see retained earnings?
Second page is red.
Revenue sources. It's shown as a negative.
Well, yeah. That's.
That's assessment to towns. They're showing a budget on the top line, and then they show revenue from retained earnings. So
what they're not showing is they're not showing the actual amount of retained earnings from the year.
No, I agree with that. It's just that number doesn't even make sense.
What they're saying is they're using $345,000 of retained earnings.
Last year.
In this current year that we're in now.
Yes.
Yeah. And that's $285,000 for the ambulance and whatever, it's $60,000 or something else.
Right. So Selectmen have already voted on this?
What's that?
Selectmen have already voted on this one?
No.
That's what it says in the notes, February 16th.
Yeah.
I don't think they had the information.
I mean, not Selectmen, yeah. Board of Oversight.
Oversight.
Yeah, they did vote that night. We had a meeting that night, we couldn't go.
Right, we had a meeting that night, we could not go.
I thought part of the oversight said that he wasn't going to get that raise.
Well, there again, I mean, who said they were? There's six members on the board of oversight. So.
From what I understand, it was not unanimous, that's for sure.
Well, it may not have been unanimous, but all he needed was four.
Right, they had four.
They had four? Vote for it?
No, sure they did.
Oh, they had to, otherwise it wouldn't have been approved.
Well, like I said, the request came to the personnel board. We asked to see what his duties were and what, you know, qualifications he had for it and whatever. We never got anything.
I'd like the IT specialist to open up that laptop and see how much the time is spent on business and how much time is spent on games.
Well, we might be better off if we spent more time on games.
Well, that could be true.
I hope that's not.
We're going to put this on hold and review and ask to give them detailed budget expenditure reports for 15 and 16?
Yeah,
and then give them a breakdown?
This is just the first shot through here to look at, and I certainly was not anticipating taking any action tonight. The only thing is, you know, I think what we want to do when we meet with the selectmen is to talk with them about.
Well, there's three people who were at the meeting on the 16th.
Right, so maybe they can explain some of this stuff. Right.
They should be able to explain it all. Our financial advisor, chairman of the select board.
There's also a capital.
I see that.
Request, yeah.
But I don't know why. I don't understand that either. If you look back in 14, 15 and 16, when you're talking about stretch a load system, it was 5,000. That's from retained earnings, they held that. And then now they're requesting 20 this year, so that's a total of 30.
The stretchers that they're looking for, there's two of them that they
that facility sold out is $110,000.
That's for the new building.
Just to buy furniture.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
And then 51 for the ambulance is a standard one. Medical equipment typically is 40. They didn't put anything in this year, but they did.
They did, but they put it over on the side, I think.
They increased
their.
They broke
it out. They broke it out instead.
They increased their.
So this capital request don't match the what the capital improvement committee was asked for.
They didn't have the 110 on the capital improvement.
They didn't have the 110.
They had about $50,000.
The only thing that was 92. We saw two stretcher load systems. And two IV pumps.
Three IV pumps.
Three.
Was it?
Yeah.
Three.
They
okay.
Want three for your
home. Yeah, that's right. Three IV pumps, and they needed two.
Yeah, we got
load systems.
Well, it says 57,000 on what John passed out last night, and for the ambulance, it's got 51.
51 is the next. Is right.
Yeah.
Now.
Right.
Okay.
And
replacement ambulance. That's the. Medication administration pumps for two of them, $21,000.
That sounds right.
Yeah.
If you look back, they had money in.
Our ambulance cot loaders approved for $20,000.
Right.
And that's it.
Yeah.
The 110 one didn't go to.
No, that was 30 a month ago.
What?
It's all what it
the
is now. The facility build out looks like it's remaining of their. Whatever they have left
in retained earnings.
Yeah.
Could be.
Because they put another $100,000 in reserve.
Right.
And they reduced everybody's
assessment
by 15%. So that ate up all the capital retained earnings. So they dumped the balance in facility build out. That's the way I see it.
Could be. Should we meet next week and when? And rather than invite Zach, I don't know if we have Barbara and Brenda come and talk to us about this budget.
Well,
at least some of those.
Well, I think we need to have the financial officer for the skin.
Board of Oversight
come in. That's the person that needs to explain this budget to us.
That's Carolyn, I think.
It is exactly Carolyn.
Right.
So if Carolyn wants to come in, I certainly wouldn't object.
I think she's the one that has to explain it. The other people at our office have nothing to do with this budget other than send them a bill for $60,000.
Well, Zach has been in talking with Brenda, so she has information that from those discussions.
But if we've got a guy that we're paying 70 grand a year, he should be able to come in like Kevin does or any other department.
We're paying more than Kevin.
I agree, but before we have him come in, I want to have better, more information so we can ask him questions and be, you know,
Well, then when did the expense report?
It's not, it's,
The expenditures report will tell almost everything.
Yes, so if we had that for next week.
Meeting, then, but I still think we need to have the finance director for.
So we ask Carolyn or whomever.
Yep, I think she needs to be here to be able to explain.
Maybe even have, ask Kippy if he could come in and talk to us about the building.
We can't.
Building's got nothing to do with us.
Can't.
He can't.
He can't, he physically.
They turned over the property from what I understand, and whatever we get, we get.
Exactly.
And you can't interfere with that one bit because you do.
I'm just curious as to where that stands.
We can't even ask the question.
We're not even supposed to discuss that.
We don't even, all we know, we get a building coming, and when we get it, we get it.
Whatever we get, we get.
All right.
And we don't even have a say in the color.
Nope.
Or the fixtures, or the driveway.
Has that been set down, has we been set down on that?
Who's,
yeah, they're.
Yeah.
Deerfield's coming tomorrow.
So are you talking, Skip, next Tuesday?
That's fine with me.
Is that, we've been meeting on Tuesdays lately, so. What time?
What's 26th?
28th.
And then, and mentioned to Carolyn, getting together next week and really going over the, say, the omnibus budget. We got questions, but to then go over it in depth and see if we can get that straightened out.
Do we have a tentative on the 29th with them?
That's what we.
That's what I have. Meeting Select Board and Finance Committee.
Yeah.
At 6:30, and then.
And so we would get together on Tuesday to.
Capital Improvement Committee at 5:30.
When?
On the 29th, the same day, right, yeah.
So are you okay with 2 days? 2 nights?
We're doing it this way.
Tuesday the 28th and Wednesday the 29th. 6:30 for both.
Anybody vehemently opposed to that?
I'm just saying, 4 nights next week, that's all.
I know, I'm.
So that's.
We gotta meet whatever we gotta meet.
Okay.
Next Tuesday, next Wednesday, we do it.
Let me have some.
And I'll see if I can.
So the idea is that we'll have all the budgets, well, we still wanted this one finalized, but in the 29th, what's the reason?
If we can, if, Kevin, I think, is due back on Monday, but, so we need to talk with Kevin to get that wastewater treatment plant. Unless you guys have a better handle on that, which you probably do, you should.
We do not.
But.
We really don't.
I'd love to have a better handle. If you wanna check the emails.
No, I don't wanna check anybody's emails. Definitely.
We have a copy of them all.
I can't even go through mine.
It's ridiculous.
I think the whole committee wish we had a better handle on it.
Oh, no doubt.
My impression.
Yeah, we're just.
Do you wanna talk with the selectmen about that tonight and get, we start the ball rolling?
About what?
Just tell them we're, we've looked at the budget request for, and it's just, it was up $100,000 last year, it's up $100,000 this year. We've got from 250, or 200, $250,000 to over $500,000 in 2 years.
We know there's certain things that have to be done, but we don't know how much they're gonna cost.
Yeah.
And they're being piecemealed in, and we have no idea. So we, it's not even our charge to look at budget.
Okay.
Our charge is to look at what might be done in the future and what we have investigated relative to rate structure. That's our charge.
Then we're done.
We've been done a long time ago. I mean, if you read the minutes, I don't even have to write them anymore, just take.
Spinning the wheels.
Just take minutes and just check off what we did say again. I'm sorry. I made submissions, you made submissions on what we should do.
Which one of the, are all three selectmen involved with that too, or?
No, only Kippy.
Kippy.
But we are looking at management areas, which I think is a good idea, but it took us 12 months to get there. 13 months.
I think the management.
We talked about it a long time ago, and we finally got to them, but. I'm saying.
The, just as an aside, it has nothing to do with us, but I'll throw it out anyways. The South Deerfield Water District is still hunting for someone to run for commissioners.
Two people.
Two and maybe three, because the third one has said I'm going.
I've already done that once.
Yeah.
You don't want to do it again?
That wouldn't be expected that the third one would turn around and resign, but right now.
Well, no, as I understand it, as of July 1st, that the third one may be.
Do we know why? No, we can't say why.
Well, I don't know that.
Can't say it on TV.
I don't know that there's any particular reason, maybe there is.
Well, I think there is, but I.
But, well.
But I would not go back and take, and actually be part of that commission again.
The problem is that, as I understand it, if worse comes to worse, then the town's stuck with it.
Well, that's a good thing, because we got a lot of money.
Well, no, that's, I don't think that's a good thing.
They got enough money to pay off every one of their debts in full right up front.
Yep.
And still extra money.
But I don't want that money coming into the town, because I can see.
It's gone.
I can see.
It has more flexibility if you can leave it as a district.
Right.
That's right.
It's easier, just like the fire department, we're better off to leave it.
Yep.
As two separate districts.
I absolutely agree. I mean, I can see saying.
Otherwise, then they won't be able to get any more fancy trucks after that. No more than 2.5%. And then they'd have to compete against every other town function, so we're better off leaving it as is. And everybody knows that.
They actually get paid, though. They get paid to be on that.
We do.
$3,000. $1,200?
That's a lot of money.
$1,200, I think.
Yeah, I don't remember.
I think the Prudential Committee at the fire department only gets $700 or $800.
I think it's $1,200 a month.
So if you do both, John.
Yeah, you can do both.
You meet every 2 weeks.
It'll interfere with my vacations.
Which is all the time, right?
Well, no, I only take 3 weeks in the fall and 3 weeks in the spring, and another 6 weeks down the Cape, but that's sporadic.
But how about if you took, you know, 2 weeks, because you get, there are some.
I'm practicing for retirement. It takes me a long time to get into that.
Some months have 5 Mondays in it. So if you use that, that took the third or the fourth, fifth Mondays off or whatever it is, that extra Monday, you could take your 2 weeks off 3 or 4 times a year.
I already do.
I'll kid aside. You know, that holds true for every committee, including this one. You know, this year you got Bruce, me, John, brand new. You're going to be around how much longer? Stanley's all done, what, this year?
He's done this year. So. But I said I'd do the balance of my term.
Which is what, another year?
Another year, I think.
Okay.
2 more years.
Well, this year and one more.
No, I have 3 year term.
Oh, you do. But I'm talking about Mary.
Yes.
You're one more season. One more season.
One more, I think.
You know, and I, you know, we really should start looking around. And
well, we've been doing that for 25 years.
Well, yeah, I know, but I
and
mean,
they've talked about it on TV, and they talked about it before they had a TV.
Well, I have one other person that will, I think, pretty sure that will do this.
Oh, well, that I can quit earlier.
No, you can't.
Well, I, you know, there again, if there's anybody that's in the office, I think they ought to be invited to some of these meetings. And
no, they'll discourage.
And I'll tell you
then
something.
Then they won't say they'll do it.
Well, yeah, but you know, it's.
It's completely different from what you think it is.
Yes, and I want to say something, but not while the camera's going.
Just turn off the sound. We don't know whether the sound is on or not.
I thought he said the audio was, but there's a red light going, so.
All right, let's go see what the selectmen.
It is a serious matter.
We want to adjourn for Monday night.
I agree.
Just to be.
No, we can. We'll adjourn.
You do it automatically after we get through.
Yeah.
If we even talk.